What's wrong? Killing Shelly again, Naomi. Let's go there. Okay, wonderful people, beautiful people. It is your favorite Achalugo, Dera Gizel, on the microphone. If you are new to my channel, I am Chidera Gizel, a Nigerian lifestyle vlogger living in Owerri, Imo State. Welcome to my channel. No, take the front seat, the water go. So, you guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, depending on whenever you're watching this video. I'm off to the place where they will weave my clothes. I made some beautiful clothes and I'm going to weave them, and from there I'll ship them to Lagos. So from the place where I'm going to weave the clothes, I'll be off to Ebu Road, where almost all the transport companies in Imo State are. You guys, this vlog is going to be fun. You know, there's no dumb moment to Dera Gizel baby on the microphone, so I just decided to start this vlog here, and welcome. Yeah. I didn't eat that morning before leaving the house because I was hurrying to go do this review. So I saw this place where they sell roasted corn, roasted yam and plantain. Corn didn't enter my mouth. I bought it, I ate there, and I was off to go with my clothes. And from there, I went to GIG terminal and shipped the outfits. And this terminal is so close to Relief Market. So I passed Relief Market and I saw people selling ube, and I got all of this ube for 200 naira. Although I was so tired when I got home, so I forgot to bring it out from the nylon and it was already spoiling. But if you're an ube expert here, you know that if it's spoiling, that's when it's getting sweet. The spoiler, the merrier, if there's any English like that. Are you getting me?
You guys, ube is ready. Oh my god, you guys see this small ube? I've never seen ube small like this in my life before. Seriously, this camera is magnifying this thing. Let me shift a bit. It's still looking big on the camera, compared to my finger. See, it's like the tip of my thumb. Very small. See this one too. Jesus, I've never seen a ube small like this before. See the normal ones. Guys, I don't know why this camera is making this thing look bigger, but it's small. You guys should come and join me. Who loves ube? If you're an ube lover, signify in the comment section. Must you take ube with corn, or you can take only ube? Like me now, taking the ube alone, no corn. And I did take them alone, and I'm gonna enjoy it. So let's do this. Let me even taste this small one and give you guys feedback now. See the seed, very small. It's really nice.
So you guys, good morning. So this is a brand new day and baby girl is in the kitchen. Yeah, that work, that job I went to send the clothes off for, that job really kept me busy for days. I couldn't cook for days. I didn't have time to cook. I just wanted to finish the job. I was just focusing on it, everything. So it took my time. So now that that job is off my head, I'm here in the kitchen and I'm cooking beans and corn. I don't know what's wrong with me this morning. Anyways, I'm cooking beans and corn. I learned how to eat this in Ife. Ife is in Osun State. My university, Obafemi Aluwa University, Ile Ife, was in Ife. And I met a lot of people there that used to eat beans and corn. I had a lot of Yoruba friends, so I learned it from them, beans and corn. You guys, beans and corn is heavenly. If you have never tried it, try it and thank me later. Beans and corn porridge. Oh my god. So the beans is currently cooking because beans is very strong and it takes time to get done. But I quickly want to bring out the corn from, how do they call it? Is it the corn in a bit? Please somebody help me with the English. Yeah, so I want to bring out the corn and pick it one by one so that I can put it inside the food. So I have to be really fast before the beans will get too soft and all of that. And after that, I'll cut the onions and you guys should just cook with me, as usual. Cook with Dera baby on the microphone. Oh yeah, let's go there.
Thank you.
got this corn yesterday when I went to God is good for the way bill. So I'm just going to pick it. I put it in the fridge so it won't spoil. So I'm going to pick it right now and put it into the beans. So you guys, I don't know if there's anybody that can suggest the best way to remove corn from its this thing, because this was so difficult. It took me a lot of time. By the time I was done, the beans was already kind of soggy, although beans can never ever get too soft. Yeah, I always prefer when it's even too soft to when it's very very strong, but the corn took me like forever to remove. So if you have any technique for doing this, please do let me know. Yeah, and so I prepared my onions. I cut it into tiny bits. Yeah, before I was not a fan of using chopping board for onions, but all of a sudden I'm not a fan of using chopping board. I don't like using my hands. And you guys, identify in the comment section if you always use seasoning cubes, aka Maggi, for your beans. If my mom is in the kitchen and you dare use Maggi for beans, well, anyway, small Maggi cannot harm somebody, I beg. And if you are a huge fan of crayfish, let me know in the comment section. To me, I love crayfish just like White Money, my guy in Bibi Nigeria. I love crayfish a lot. Yeah, and I put in pepper. I use this red pepper, the orange pepper, because black pepper always makes food black. And I added another crayfish again, and then I put in the palm oil, and oh my god, I let it cook for a while, and ta-da, our beans and corn is ready. Yes, I love my beans to burn a bit at lower part. I still left it on the pot, I mean on the gas, for a little while, because the bottom part is always the sweetest, which is why I always pray for both the bottom part blessings when I am praying. And you guys, here is our delicacy. Oh my god, I feel like jumping into the screen and eating this again and again and again, but it shines at my compound soccer way. I'm so silly, gosh. So you guys, come and join me. This is actually great. Anyways, while I was at God is Good yesterday, I remembered something terrible that happened to me 2 years ago, and I decided that I was going to tell you guys the story, but when I got back yesterday, I was so busy, so I couldn't say it. So let me tell you guys the story now. So that 2 years ago, my sister came to Owerri for a burial. Like, she didn't even know she was going to stay in Owerri for long. That was how she moved to Owerri. So she came for a burial. Last, she ended up staying back. She didn't come back after a month, 2 months. So she said I should help her pack her things in a box, and I should have her certificate. She told me where everything was. I packed everything, I put it into the box, and I went to Peacemass Transit, because she said Peacemass Transit would be the best place for me to send it to her from. So I went to Peacemass Transit. As I got there was this guy at the gate, hello, greeting me, good afternoon. And normally I do wave bill. I used to wave bill to my mom in Port Harcourt then, through Chisco. And once I go, I will go to their office. So that day, I didn't even want to talk to the guy, but the guy was really there. I should tell him now. So I greeted him. And that's the greatest mistake you make, greeting them. So I greeted him. And I said, okay. He now took me inside a place. So when he took me inside that place, I assumed that that was the office in peace. I didn't know that the office was at another side. So he finished telling me everything. He said he's the driver of a bus. He showed me a particular bus that he's the driver of the bus and all of that. So I gave the guy the box. I even paid 8,000 naira because it was a very big box. He said, okay, I bought a new full seat, that he would get one seat for it to sit down on one seat. They can't pack it as normal load, this one. So I paid 8,000 naira for the box and everything. So I left it with him and I left. So I think when I got home, my mom was not asking me how I sent it, and I told her. She now said that I would have gone to the office. I said the guy took me inside the place, that inside the room in that place now, something like that. She was like, okay, let you get there safely. I think after 2 or 3 days, my sister had not yet gotten the box. She was not calling the guy. She was not calling that, yeah, he will say that he's on the road. My sister will not call me and say that the place he is not sounding as if he's road. It's sounding quiet. It's sounding too quiet. So one evening like that, maybe around 7, 8 in the evening, my mom now called me that she hurry now. I should be going to Peacemass Transit. I should go to their office. I should ask them about the guy. I should show them the number. Okay. Hey, in the night. I said, how would I start going to park in the night? That is very, very risky. How would I go to a bus park in the night?
We were not arguing. My sister was calling. My sister was crying. There is not even her clothes that is her problem. That is her certificate that is her problem. That she find her, we go to that Christmas transit and tell her that they should look for that guy. She has been calling him since morning. He's not straightforward. Come on, come on. Sha. After everything, I think after about 4 or 5 days, my sister later got the box. But here's what happened. When she got the box, she opened the box and her certificates were not inside the box. So she now called the guy, the driver guy, that should be a driver, that there are some things that are inside the box that are not supposed, that are inside the box that are supposed to be here, that they are not here. This one down. The driver now said, oh, now he just defined that say something no day inside and all of that. You know that this guy blackmailed my sister. My sister had to give him, I think, 20,000 naira to collect her certificate, because when he brought it out, he saw that it was something very important. NIC discharge certificate, IMSU certificate, all those. She paid extra 20,000 naira to get those certificates. That's why since then, if I go back, if you try greet me, the way I'll burn my face, and you think that maybe I know you from your village and maybe you're dragging for my land or something. I won't even talk to you. I'll not talk to anybody. What do you want? Mom, deaf and dumb. Adam will be immediately. Ignore me. That's what I'll do to you. I'll just ignore. When I get to the counter, I'll just ask, please, is this the logistics place? If they say yes, even if the logistics is going to take a lot of time, I'd rather do it than to do driver express, because what most of them do is that you may even get that thing safely. Yes, you may get it safely, but the problem is that when the person now goes to pick it up there, they'll now start asking the person for extra money. They'll now start telling you that you should settle them. Different things, especially if the distance is long. If the distance is just Uber to Port Harcourt, you can take that risk. But if the distance is long, it's just better to go through their logistics and all of that and get everything done the normal way, because something must shall happen. K-leg must shall enter, especially if it's a journey that takes up to 8 hours, 10 hours. If it's just 2 hours journey, 3 hours journey, you can easily trust a driver. But personally, I just prefer, if I don't know the driver personally, I'm not going to send it through him. I'll just go to their office, register it. If the office not likes, they should give it to driver by themselves, so that if anything happens, I will have who to hold liable. Because apparently that guy was not even a bus driver. That's what we later discovered. He was not a bus driver. He's just all these stouts that stay in the back. He gave it to a driver and he still blackmailed my sister and collected extra money from her. So I just felt I should share the story here, so that in case anybody is about to fall into that trap, you won't fall into that trap. Just gonna register it in the office. If it takes 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, it will get to you safely. And if anything happens to it, you have people to hold. You register it, they know what is inside, they know the monetary value and all of that. So you guys, that's going to be it for this video. I have to go off camera and eat. It's a bit distracting to be eating and talking at the same time. Like, it's hard for me. So I have to go off camera and finish the food. Yeah. So I'm going to be seeing you guys in my next video. This video should be long already. If you enjoyed this video, do give it a huge thumbs up. You guys, see my neck. See my neck. Ah, I stressed myself last week. Too much. Too much. Eh? Make I not go slim down that year. Yes, slimming down. I can attach Elsa this week. I will eat well this week. I will cook well this week. You guys should expect more mouth-watering, more longer throat-ish videos. I will cook well this week and eat very well. I regain my energy. So you guys, I'm going to be seeing you in another video. If you enjoyed this video, do give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Subscribe, please. Share this video. Let's move the ministry to the permanent site. And hopefully, I'm going to be seeing you in my next video. For now, bye, kiss, love ya.